welcome everybody to Mount Van Hovenberg for the cross-country skiing at the 2023 FISU World University Games. And we're getting ready for the men's 10K. And our early starters are getting warmed up. There are 84 athletes in the field today, and they will start at 30-second intervals. So my maths tells me that that will take 42 minutes to get everyone out onto the course. There's two laps of the 5K track. If you watch the women's contest, you've seen that it's a very difficult track. Very steep climbs and very fast and technical descents. So yeah, two 5 kilometer laps, and the best ranked skiers will go last. So it will be a slow build, and we will build towards the faster skiers towards the end of the race. So let's have a look at the start list. Jan Mikus of Slovakia will get us underway. Eden Kirkham of Canada. Now, Jaime Peo, number 21, medalist in the sprint competition. Watch out for him. Gustavo Karsrud as well. Finn Sweet and Veneri Poikkanen of Finland, 41 and 42. Finn was a medalist in the team competition. Poikkanen took the gold in the sprint. Now, you can have cross-country skiers that are good in sprint and in distance, but sometimes they split, and sometimes they can be good in both, and others are only good in sprint. Will Koch there from the United States, and Hirose of Japan, number 80, took the gold medal in the team competition. So watch out for him. Magnus Boyer of Norway, disappointed in the sprints, had a bit of bad luck. And Tom Mancini will be the last skier to ski. Watch out for him. He got bronze in the individual. So Jan Mikus of Slovakia from the Technical University of Zvolen will get us underway. So if you just look at this very first hill, you'll be able to see how well. Oh, he's double poling all the way up that. Pretty much looking good there for Jan Mikus. Paul Fromander from Darmstadt. It doesn't matter if you go early on the beeps, because it's the wand. When the wand that you see at their shins, when that gets broken open, that's when their timer starts. And the beeps really are just a guideline. You can't go too early. Number six there is Caio Brown of Brazil. Oh, and what's going on here? This is the initial descent. Oh, just stood on the inside ski there as he was stepping around the turn. And yeah, a little bit of a disappointment early doors. And there's going to be some more high-speed turns coming up as they reach the top of this hill and then descend. And there is the athlete from Thailand, Kosin. And his speed considerably less than some of the other skiers. But it is a long day out. And there is our early leader. It's very early days yet. Faster skiers haven't even started yet. We're at the 2.5K. Robin Locker is seventh. No Bradford there. Well, number 11. That is Bondar of Ukraine, and he has taken the lead by 5 seconds at 2.5K. And there is Paul Fromander, and he will lead as we go around. And along the start finish straight. So at 5K, Fromander leads. This is Juha Numeri. And Juha Numeri is 11 seconds up at 2.5K. So again, they're going to get quicker and quicker as the race goes on. Juha Numeri of Finland from the National Defense University. So starting with bib 41, it's Finsweet from the University of Vermont, winner of the team silver competition. Tim Sweet.
Mixed relay, and there he goes now.
Sophomore at the University of Vermont, 20 years old, off and running. So Aiden Kirkham has just come through for his second lap in the lead, just taking the lead for Canada. It's a good ski from Kirkham. Picked up a lot of time on the second half of that 5K loop. You can see the athletes who haven't started yet, just warming up near the wax cabins. So halfway point in the race, and Ruslan Denisenko is up, 21 seconds up over Kirkham of Canada. Juha Numeri of Finland into the lead, 20 seconds up. That is a good ski from the first leg for the Finn. So number two there is Paul Fromander. He is getting pretty close to the finish line. Finn Sweet is looking good at 2.5K, taking the lead. So our very first finisher, our second finisher there actually. So the first one to cross the line was Mikus. So the Finn Juha Numeri, as expected, takes the lead at 7.5 kilometers in. But Finn Sweet has just gone through the start finish line and is 15 seconds up over Numeri of Finland. And there he is there, 41. He is skiing faster than the Finn. So 15 seconds up. So coming on to the finish straight is Aiden Kirkham. And Kirkham looking good, and Kirkham takes the lead a whole minute ahead.
Almost a minute.
We drop back to the start finish line, and Juha Numeri does take the lead, 41 seconds ahead. Now that's a good ski, but I feel that that will be bettered as we go on, because I know that Finn Sweet was ahead of Numeri at the halfway point. As we go back to the start, and it is Hiroshi Ryo of Japan, winner of the team gold, and powerfully out wearing bib 80. So it is Andreas Kerkeng wearing bib 81 from the University of Denver, winner of a team bronze so far. Can he add to that medal tally?
And there he goes. He's going to be joined by another racer.
We see racers crossing the line and racers starting simultaneously. This is where all the action is right now. So Magnus Boyer of Norway from the University of Colorado at Boulder.
He's yet to make it onto the podium.
Magnus Boyer disappointed in the sprint competitions, had a little bit of a bad luck. Flag bearer for the Norwegian team, born in South Korea, competed at the Olympics in Pyeongchang for Korea. Now switching back to Norway. John Steele Hagenbutt from Dartmouth College. And welcome to our ESPN viewers. John Steele Hagenbuck, 21 years old, a sophomore at Dartmouth College. Five relatives also graduated from Dartmouth. So Finn Sweet giving absolutely everything now. The final drive for the line. This could be good enough for a medal if he really goes for it. Finn Sweet crosses the line 11 seconds ahead of Juha Nurmi of Finland. And Sweet will have to wait and watch and hope. And watch this guy, the Armenian, number 70. Mikhail Yan. So Dufek looking to challenge Finn Sweet from the USA. This split will be and will tell us all. So through the checkpoint, and I can see it. Dufek has got the lead, but it's a slender lead. It's less than a second. And that is Andreas Kirkeng of Norway going through the halfway mark with a 21-second lead over the Japanese Hirose. So watch out for Kirkeng, watch out for Hirose, winner of the team gold competition. Those two already medalists and looking to bag another today. So Kirkeng, Hirose, Mikhailyan of Armenia, Thomas Dufek. Is he going to take? He's not going to take the lead away from Sweet. It's going to be really tight. Maybe he's going to do it. Yes, he is going to do it. Oh, the narrowest of margins. Thomas Dufek from the Czech Republic takes the lead away from Finn Sweet. And that could potentially be a podium ski from Thomas Dufek. We're going to have to wait and see. We've got some really fast skiers coming up because Magnus Boyer has gone through in second place halfway through. John Steele Hagenbuch is looking good as well. And they're all quicker than the Czech. Will Koch.
Here he comes down, number 71, putting it all out there. 10.9 seconds behind.
So the time of Mikhailyan has already passed through, and 10 seconds back and fifth place. Those are the early leaders in the finish, but I can tell you that the 7.5 kilometer mark, we're looking at over Hirose of Japan. So Hirose coming back into that. Magnus Boyer of Norway in third place, 12 seconds back, and John Steele Hagenbuch, 25 seconds back in fourth. And they are all quicker than our current leader in the finish. So the action is gonna happen. amongst the skiers that are still out on the track. So the medals will come. Well, not for Mancini, though. Mancini has had some problems. And Mancini, well, he is in 20th place.
81 on 8. 81.
So Mancini, the last skier on the track, is not going to be challenging for the medals. We're looking for numbers 80 to 83. That's where our medals are going to come from. And 81 in particular, Andreas Kerkeng. We're looking at the split at 9.6K with just 400 meters away from the finish. The first one through that split will be number 80, and there he is. So that is Hirose Ryo, winner of the team gold competition. He's starting that descent. He will then ski down the hill, and then there's a little bit where it kicks back up again just before the finish. Andreas Kerkeng also approaching the top of the big climb. He's given absolutely everything. He's leading, or was leading, at 7.5K. Double poling up the hill. It's the quickest way to ski, but the most energy sapping. Really giving everything here. Top of the hill for Andreas Kerkeng. And at the 9.6 kilometer mark, the Japanese skier Hirose has gone through with a 36 second lead. So Hirose will ski the final section into the stadium as we watch Kerkeng come through. So Kerkeng, Hirose leads at 9.6K. And Kerkeng, this is the split here. We'll watch Kerkeng through this final split, and then I think we're gonna have to go to the start-finish line. Now here it is. This is the Japanese skier, Hirose, onto the start-finish line. I can tell you that Kerkeng has gone through the split behind Hirose. Hirose coming in here with a storming second lap. Hirose absolutely nailed the second lap there and takes the lead away. So Hirose goes into gold medal position, and I don't think that Kerkeng is going to challenge him. So Andreas Kerkeng, who led Hirose and almost caught him halfway through, well, Hirose put on the afterburners, and Hirose has now crossed the line in gold medal position. And that could well be the gold medal ski, because I don't think that Andreas Kerkeng is going to be able to challenge the leader. He's definitely on for a potential silver medal here. But Andreas Kerkeng looks to be spent. He does not have the sprinting speed of Hirose Ryo. And crosses the line in second place. And the second lap was really tough for the Norwegian. And the Japanese skier was able to time the energy just right. Magnus Boya coming onto the finish line now. Could this be the bronze medal ski or the silver medal? Goes into second. Magnus Boya takes the silver medal.
Securing the silver medal.
So steals it away from his teammate, Andreas Kerkeng. We still have one more skier, John Steele Hagenbuch. Can he do something? John Steele Hagenbuch from the USA, from Dartmouth College. Going to be close, but I think he's just going to miss the medals.
He'll be about 35 seconds off the pace, and here he comes right now through the finish line.
And John Steele Hagenbuch in seventh place. We can confirm that Ryo Hirose from Japan, smiling into the sun that's been bursting out today. Rio Rossi is our men's 10K individual classic winner. Great for the Japanese. Two gold medals at these World Winter University Games. The two Norwegians, Magnus Boje and Andreas Kirkeng in silver and bronze, but it is gold to Hirose Ryo of Japan. So representing Norway, Andreas Kirkeng. Went hard, set the early pace, and then the wheels rather fell off.
Second place, representing Norway, Magnus Boje.
Magnus Boje of Norway from the University of Colorado in Boulder. Both the Norwegians at the university over in the States.
And in first place, and cross-country men's 10-kilometer individual classic champion representing Japan, Ryo Hirose.
So Hirose takes the gold from Waseda University in Japan, and it's his second gold of these games. So they will be presented with their medals later this evening in Main Street in Lake Placid. But congratulations to our medalists. They get to take away their mascots.
Through the finish line.
Going out of the start. He's on his way to the finish.
The gap closing ever tighter.
Yo,